what the game's going to look and feel like as we get started.
そうですね、こんな早い段階で実はライブでも行うのは初めてで、どんなポケモンが出るかっていうのもちょっと世界初公開のポケモンを登場するかもしれない
ちょっとドキドキ
しますね。This is actually the first time for us to show a Pokemon game at this stage in development via live gameplay. So, not really sure exactly what we're going to encounter on this. We may see some all new Pokemon that haven't been revealed before.
My fingers crossed, that'd be really cool. Actually, as we get started here, Masuda-san, Nomori-san, can you tell us a little bit aboutthe story and the background of what's going on right now in the game?
今ここで主人公は何をしている場面なんでしょうか。
そうですね、主人公はですね、アローラ地方に引っ越してきたばかりという設定になっています。で今回すでに、少し進めていまして、最初のポケモンはすでに、もらっています。今から、リリータウンというところでお祭りが開催されるので、そこに向かうところです。
So at this point in the game, it's a little bit, slightly into it, but it's, the player actually had just moved to the Alola region, the other day, and, one day previous to where we are in the game, he actually, received his first partner Pokemon for his adventure. And right now we're actually on the way to a neighboring town where there's a festival.
Oh.
And I think here, we can see what we were talking about earlier. Oh, you're just jumping into the little girls.
びっくりする。レディバーですね。
レディバーアローラ地方には他の地方のポケモンも出てきます。
So as you can see, the Alola region, obviously it's not just new Pokemon that are unique to the Alola region, but from other regions you see Pokemon.
今回トレーナーとポケモンっていうものもしっかり描きたいと思って、トレーナーが一緒にこうポケモンの後ろにいるっていう。ところを再現してますね。
And as you can see here in battle, you see the trainer is actually standing behind, the Pokemon, in the battle. So we really wanted to express this, feeling of the trainer always being with his or her Pokemon.
Yeah, I'd love to talk about that in a little bit more detail here, because I feel like there's so much that you've done with, the way the battle looks in this game to make it feel really intense and really immersive. I was wondering if we could talk a little bit more about that with what you did with, the lighting and the dynamic camera angles here.
やっぱ没入感を高めるっていう話もちょっと、出てきたんですけども、やっぱ今回こう演出とか見た目が、違ってて、光の表現とかもありますね。
そうですね。ちょっと時間によって影が長くなったりとかっていうのも入ってたりしますね。
So yeah, there's some cool lighting, effects that we're doing here where, for example, the shadow, you see it's, in the evening right now, so it's a bit longer, but depending on the time of day, the lighting will kind of affect the mood of the battle.
I think here, Terry's kind of staying still for a second to let us see how the camera is moving around. And this is something that'll just happen for you if you're staying still in the battle for a moment, and you really get a good chance to get a look at these Pokemon and the area that you're in and the environment.
まあこうやって一回、テリー今止まってくれてるんですけども、まあこうカメラの演出を見せたりとか、まあ結構やっぱりこういうかっこいいカメラの演出があって、すごいこうバトルフィールドの全体を見合わせするような感じになってますね。
今回カメラもすごいダイナミックさっていうのを非常に意識して演出を入れています。
So yeah, there's, definitely some cool, we tried to make the camera feel really dynamic, in the battles this time around.
And actually, as, Terry gets started in the battle here, I was wondering if we could talk a little bit more about, the different changes you've made to the battle interface. I know there's a lot here that's really interesting, which makes the game really accessible to new players. Maybe this is their first Pokemon game, but it's also, I think, really satisfying as someone who's played a lot of Pokemon games. It feels really good, the changes that you've made here.
結構ベテランにもやっぱ初心者にも結構優しい感じの、インターフェースにちょっと前、今まで違う印象があるんですけども、どういう、変更を加えたんでしょうか。
そうですね、今回とても、親切なというか説明がいろいろ入れています。例えばその、インフォメーションボタンがあるんですけども、そちらをタッチすると今その技がどんな技かっていうのを一目で分かるようになっています。
So for example, yeah, we really tried to focus on making it really accessible and easy to understand. You saw the moves there. Terry just pressed the little eye button or the icon that's on the move, and you can go into a detailed explanation of what that move actually does.
I think it's been so helpful.There's just so many Pokemon that you have to keep in mind now as you're battling. It's so nice to be able to pull it up, and if maybe you don't quite remember what something does, being able to just pop it up really fast there, it's like you don't have to use that information, but if maybe your memory's not as good as it used to be and you need it, it's so nice to be able to pull that up and take a look.
タッチしてもらえると、今どんな状態かというのが分かるようになっています 。
So actually you can see there's the, you can tap on the, 2D Pokemon icon that's on the touch screen and see how its parameters actually just got changed, because of the effect of a move.
今まで全部覚えてなきゃいけなかったんですけど、これで一目でわかるよ。
So as you just said, like a lot of things you had to keep in your head, you had to remember before, now visualize on the interface itself.